Of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And today we celebrate the feast of the Exaltation of the Holy Cross. We celebrate what, in fact, the finding of what the Crusader or the early Christians believed was the actual cross on which Jesus died. But we remember that what we're celebrating is not just some piece of bling, not some nice silver jewelry or gold jewelry that we hang around our necks, but an actual instrument of torture, an actual very rough wooden structure to which Jesus Christ was nailed and upon which he hung for 3 hours in agony. So as we always do, we spend a few moments calling to mind our sins, realizing that it was for the forgiveness of our sins that Jesus died on the cross. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
See.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who willed that your only begotten Son should undergo the cross to save the human race, grant, we pray, that we who have known his mystery on earth may merit the grace of his redemption in heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. So this first reading from the book of Numbers, it tells of a strange incident when fiery serpents attacked the people of Israel in the desert because they were complaining about the conditions in the desert. And God told Moses to make a bronze serpent and to raise it up on a staff, and anyone who looked on it would be healed of the bite, of the pain of the bite of the fiery serpents.
Triumph of the Cross. A reading from the book of Numbers. On the way through the wilderness, the people lost patience. They spoke against God and against Moses. Why did you bring us out of Egypt to die in the wilderness? For there is neither bread nor water here. We are sick of this unsatisfying food. At this, God sent fiery serpent among the people. They bite brought death to many in Israel. The people came and said to Moses, "We have sinned by speaking against the Lord and against you. Intercede for us with the Lord to save us from these serpents." Moses interceded for the people, and the Lord answered him, "Make a fiery serpent and put it on a standard. If anyone is bitten and looks at it, he shall live." So Moses fashioned a bronze serpent, which he put on a stand. And if anyone was bitten by the serpent, he looked at this bronze serpent and lived. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Never forget the deeds of the Lord.
Never forget the deeds of the Lord.
Give heed, my people, to my teaching. Turn your ear to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable and reveal hidden lessons of the past. Never forget the deeds of the Lord. When he slew him, then they will seek him. Return and seek him in earnest. They will remember that God was their rock, God the Most High, their Redeemer. Never forget the deeds of the Lord. But the words they spoke were more flattery. They lied to him with their lips, for their hearts were not truly with him. They were not faithful to his covenant. Never forget the deeds of the Lord. Yet he who is full of compassion, forgive their sin and spare them. So often he held back his anger, when he might have stirred up his rage. Never forget the deeds of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. The state of Jesus Christ was divine, yet he did not cling to his equity with God, but emptied himself to assume the condition of a slave and become a man, a minah. And being as all men are, he was humble yet, even to accept death on the cross, But God raised him high and gave him the name, which is above all other name, so that all beings in heaven, on earth, and in the underworld should bend and then the knees at the name of Jesus, and that every tongue shall acclaim Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We adore you, O Christ, and we bless you. Because of your cross, you have redeemed the world.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to Nicodemus, "No one has gone up to heaven except the one who has come down from heaven, the Son of Man who is in heaven. And the Son of Man must be lifted up, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so that everyone who believes may have eternal life in him. Yes, God loved the world so much that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not be lost, but may have eternal life. For God sent his Son into the world, not to condemn the world, but so that through him the world might be saved." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. So that's probably the most quoted verse of the whole Bible. That God loved the world so much that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not be lost, but may have eternal life. And that's, you know, that sums up our faith in so many ways. But, you know, what we're celebrating here is a historical fact. And the fact is that the Son of God, Jesus Christ, the second person of the Most Blessed Trinity, became a human being like us, shared our human nature fully, and that he, in showing us how to achieve eternal happiness and happiness in this life, he confronted evil with good, lies with the truth, wrong with the right, and hatred with love. And he knew that would lead him into trouble. He knew that would lead to suffering and ultimately to death. And the death was the death on the cross. And he said, if anyone wants to be his disciple, he must take up his cross daily and follow him. And the cross that Jesus is talking about is not a fancy piece of jewelry. It's not something in gold or silver that we hang around our necks and like to show off. It's not a piece of bling. It's an actual instrument of torture. It's a very, very rough wooden structure to which Jesus was attached by nails. So what did he mean? And what does he mean for us by taking up your cross and following him? It means facing the difficulties and the temptations and the problems of life, and confronting the evil, confronting the wrong in our own lives in the same way that Jesus did. Not with hatred, not with lies, not with anger, but with love and with truth and with goodness. And that's something very, very difficult, because each and every one of us has to struggle against our own fallen human nature. We have to struggle to face the challenges in our families, in our neighborhood, in our country, in the world, financial troubles, sickness, all kinds of problems and difficulties. But how do we face those? How do we confront those? If we do it with anger and vexation and maybe even lies and stretching the truth, then we're not following Christ. We're not following the Christian way. Taking up the cross means every day facing those difficulties and the challenges of each day, not with hatred, not with anger, but with truth and goodness and beauty and love. And that means in my own personal life, facing the temptations and the that confront each and every one of us every day. We are all subject to temptation. Each one, you know, looking the easy way, presenting itself out. Well, curse that person back. Well, do this, practice this little bit of dishonesty, nobody will notice. Confronting that every day in our own personal lives. And as I said also, right in the heart of our own homes, perhaps our own family members, our family difficulties of one kind or another. In our neighborhood, perhaps neighbors giving trouble, perhaps neighbors who are sick or difficult in whatever way, and of course in our country at the level, at the national level, and even in the whole world. But it's only by beginning with ourselves, with taking up our own cross, that that we truly follow Jesus. There's a little story. It's a bit simplistic, really, but let me tell it anyway. It's a story about, the purpose of the story is to illustrate that each person's cross is unique, that my cross is different from yours. You may have a much heavier cross than I have, or I may see your cross as very light in comparison to mine. But each of us, the cross that each one of us has to bear, is unique to that person. And God gives each one the grace, the gift, the strength, the courage to carry one's own cross. But we also have to reach out and try to assist others in carrying their crosses. So the story is just, as I said, a bit simplistic, but it's about a certain man who had a very difficult cross. And he really was suffering under this cross, and he asked God to take it away. He said, "Lord, this cross, this trouble that you've given me, this cross is too great. I can't carry it." And God said, "Well, okay, come inside." And God showed him into a big room full of crosses of all shapes and sizes and all different materials. And he said, "You look around there now, leave yours there, and pick up whatever one you feel would be suitable for you." So he looked around and he found a nice little cross, which was quite small. And he said, I'll try this." So he took that and he carried it for some time. And then he realized that it was very heavy and it was cutting into his shoulder, and he really didn't want it. So he went back to God, and God said, "Well, no problem, return it and pick another one." So he looked around and he found one. It was big, but it seemed to be very light. It seemed to be almost made of styrofoam. So it was very light, and he thought, "Well, I can handle this." But when he took it out, he found that it was causing obstruction everywhere and couldn't get through the door, and it really was a nuisance. So he went back again with that. And the story goes on and on of different crosses until eventually he found one. And he said, "Lord, look, I can handle this one." And God said to him, "Look carefully at that one now." And then he realized that the cross he had picked was the very one that God had given him to start out with. So that's, each of us has our cross to bear. And we realize that the whole purpose of why Jesus Christ suffered and died on the cross was to win forgiveness for our sins. That he confronted evil head on. He confronted it with goodness and with love. And the great example of that is that as they were nailing him to the cross, he said, "Father, forgive them because they don't know what they're doing." He didn't curse them. And that's the example to us of not giving in to cursing or vexation or anger when the cross that we are asked to carry is too heavy, but confronting that situation with that kind of love that Jesus had. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So let us stand now as we make our prayers before God. The Lord be with you.
And your spirit.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the many times that we have found our own crosses too difficult to bear, and that you have supported us and sent somebody along to put a strong right hand to help us and to raise up that cross. Lord, we ask you to give us a deep sense of the true meaning of the cross of your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, hear us. Lord, we pray for those who have exceptionally heavy crosses to bear, family problems, illness of one kind or another, or difficulties, financial troubles, Lord. Lord, we ask you to help us to reach out a helping hand to help them carry their crosses. Lord, hear us. Heavenly Father, we place all these prayers before you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good of the Lord of his name.
May the prayer of the apostles, Lord, accompany the sacrificial gift that we present to you, to your name for consecration, and may their intercession make us devoted to you in celebration of the sacrifice through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by your providence, the blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, bring us joy. Peter, foremost in confessing the faith, Paul, its outstanding preacher. Peter, who established the early church from the remnant of Israel, Paul, master and teacher of the Gentiles that you call. And so each in a different way gathered together the one family of Christ, and revered together throughout the world, they share one martyr's crown. And therefore, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy. Oh,
are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Clyde Martin, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants, Vincent and Keith, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that they who are united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. 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 Alleluia. Amen. 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 Alleluia.
And now, at the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Kingdom, the power, and the glory. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let's offer each other a little sign of peace. Peace, Cheryl. Peace, Judith. Peace, God.
Take away the sin.
judgment and condemnation. But through your loving mercy, be for me, protection in mind, the body and the healing remedy. Let this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring everlasting life to us who receive it. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Having been nourished by your holy banquet, we beseech you, Lord Jesus Christ, to bring those you have redeemed by the wood of your life-giving cross to the glory of the resurrection, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass has ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. And have a blessed rest of the day, everybody.
A student of St. Rose Modern Secondary School. On this, the 14th day in the season of creation, I invite you to pray for the end to all forms of violence and human trafficking.
O God, our Creator, you made us out of love and to be loved. Help us to care for others and respect each other. We pray for the conversion of hearts for all perpetrators of violence. Turn their hearts of stone into hearts of love. Loving Father, grant peace, comfort, and strength to all victims of violence, and eternal rest to all those who died. Amen.
Burning bush you are, glowing and endless love, living in your midst, to live
I'm Zoe, a student of the St. Rose Modern Secondary School. Today is the 13th day in the season of creation. I invite you to stop and greet someone who lives on the streets.
Burning bush you are, glowing and endless love, living in your midst, to live by you, to be alive in you.
Stand before you, Holy Spirit,
as we gather together in your name,
with you alone,
to guide us.
Make yourself at home in our hearts.
Teach us the way we must go
and how we are to pursue it.
We are weak and sinful.
Do not let us promote disorder.
Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path.
Nor partiality influence our actions.
Let us find in you our unity,
so that we may journey together to eternal life,
and not stray
from what is truth and what is right.
All this we ask of you, who are at work in every place and time.
In communion of the Father and the Son,
forever and ever.
Amen.
You've never been.